over, then I murder. Call Gunner if you want your burger. Oh, baby, you be lying in your verses. I be here and say you buying them purses. I can't even lie, you ain't my type. You ain't even know that fine in person. What's good, YouTube? It's your boy CJ. Welcome back to another video. And in this video, we're going over the best interior force build in the game. Like, come on, bro. This build, bro. Oh my god, we're about to get into it, bro. Before we do that, I'm gonna need y'all to leave a like, comment down below, and subscribe. And let's get to it. So, in summarization, bro, the first half of this video is going to be on clips and everything. I just want to show you how this build could take over. Literally, it doesn't even have a. Let me just tell y'all. He has no three-point shot, but I'm still dropping. I'm still scoring with ease. With ease, bro. Look at that. I'm just running down the court, bro. I'm playing like a freaking pure slasher, bro. But he's a power forward. This is why, bro. Like, a 6'10 dude that's catching, like, 360 alley-oops, bro. It's a problem. It's a huge problem. Look at that. Goodness gracious. This build, bro, can do anything in the paint. It's literally like an athletic paint beast. If a paint beast had, like, freaking Aaron Gordon's athleticism, bro, that's what this build is. Look at that. I'm just banging on top of kids, bro. It's easy. Easy buckets. Easy rep, especially. This is what we're going to talk about right now, actually. Rep, bro, comes so easy with this build. I was getting, like, 15K per game. We running twos with my boy, Bricks. We ran, like, five. I was getting, like, 15K every game. And now I'm at 70% to elite. I was at 50% the week prior, and I'm at 70 now, bro. We just been grinding with this lineup, bro. It's very easy to get rep. I probably, if I wanted to, I could probably hit elite one within like the next week, or no, 2 weeks, maybe the next week if I put my mind to it. But you know, I don't know. But this build, bro, let me just tell y'all, it's easy rep and easy dunks. You can get mad clips. This clip, let me tell you, these clips were in a matter of 2 days. Two days of just running with this build. I literally only have Hall of Fame contact and silver lob, bro, and this build goes crazy. Give me that. Bro, that was a game-saving block. This is the gameplay I wanted to show y'all. I didn't record the whole gameplay, so I just got footage and everything. But this build completely just took over. Took over the twos court, man. So, I got takeover. Let y'all know, man. When I get takeover, it's a wrap. It's none of my type of time, man. I don't even get all my badges yet, but it's all good. This is glass lock, bro. What the? Get off me. You know what I'm saying, man? It's that toxic. You literally win games because of that. Look at my boy still knocked. This boy still knocked. Get up, Cuddy. Just get another free point. You know what I'm saying? Bro, literally, like, there's no one on my type of time with this build, bro. Once you get takeover, it's over. Just know that the game is sealed in the bag. Just got to play right. If someone's double teaming, don't go up. See that? Patience. Just right here. Right back. And bang! Oh, my God. It's over, bro. No one's on my type of time with this build, bro. You know what I'm saying? My boy was throwing me alleys all, like, literally, like, five back-to-back possessions. This is all back-to-back. All these plays are back-to-back on this three score, at least. Watch this, watch this. This is another game I took over just because of the fact that this build is toxic. Unfortunately, this meta of this game is just find the most OP lineup. You know, pull scores, all that. It is what it is. But, you know, this build, bro, I'm telling y'all, this skill could actually take over the 1v1 court. For a great amount of time, just overpowered dunks and everything. One stop and it's over for the guards or anybody guarding you.
Nah, but I'm telling you, if y'all want that easy rep, bro, go make this build immediately. You have to. This build will literally get you to what rep you're trying to get in a matter of no time, bro. It's with ease, bro. If your teammates can throw lobs, bro, anybody can throw alleys this year. If you throw alleys, this build will catch any alley, practically any alley, unless they intercept it. But nah, bro, this build, bro, I'm not gonna say it again, bro. Just make it, man. I'm telling y'all, I literally don't even, this isn't even my main player. I use it when I want rep, when I'm trying to get rep. You know, you gotta get your clips in and everything. But I use this build, like, you know, when you're trying to get that rep up lineup, you're versing bots, or not necessarily bots, but just people. You just have fun with the build, bro. You can actually streak with this build as well. If you have like a lockdown or something, let me just show y'all. This build basically is a lockdown. You guys might be thinking, oh, gold defensive badges, bad defense. Yeah, look at me, bro. Three back-to-back blocks on this possession. Two, go up again. Three, give me that, bro. That's just straight lock. Gold defense. Anyway, let's get into how to make this build, man. All right, so now we're in the build maker. You want to go with a pure finishing pie chart.
And for the second part, you want to choose a third pie chart. For speed, for you want the most strength and the second most speed. So you can be fast and body people in the paint. So, you want to max out the finishing
up in the way I make it, you can either make the 30 finishing one, or this one, is my opinion, is the best one. I'm gonna make it a 70 hook, so you get 28 finishing, right in the borderline of it. You can go 30, like I said, but you'd get only one playmaking. So if you're trying to get quick first step and all that on gold, then I would put on the 28 finishing. So now this gives you space to upgrade that playmaking, so you can get the 12 playmaking you can get. So you could, I mean, if you want, you can get 13 by maxing out that spin. But I would go 12 because, I mean, if you have 4 gold badges and 1 bronze, why would you have 1 bronze? You know what I'm saying? So you also want to be the best on defense that you can be. You want to make this build balanced. So it's not meant to shoot this version of it. There's other tier forces that can shoot. There's some of them. But this is the version to basically get the best rep possible. So 12 playmaking, 12 defense, and 28 finishing. This build can hold its ground in the paint. It literally can do it all except for shoot. But these are the, make sure you copy these exact stats to get the most badges you can get. These are the ones I would definitely go with. So body shape doesn't matter. Burly, I don't know. I like my interior force to be skinny, not gonna lie. It just makes it look like a guard or something. So I went with compact or defined. It doesn't matter, honestly. It's your preference, the way you want your play to look. Whatever body shape. This is the most important part. 6'10 is a perfect height. 6'11, your stats go down, your driving dunk goes down, so your contact dunks, you don't get all of them. See, what you want to go with no other than 6'10. Maybe lower if you really want to, but the way this build's supposed to be made is 6'10. So you can snag on big men and do literally anything just to dominate, you know? Get that max rep you can get. Rebounds, dunks, alleys, you know, get that easy rep. And also, you can get every single contact dunk. You name it, any one of them. Not for weight. Honestly, I don't know if 245 is very bad. Honestly, I would just go no higher than 238 because you still get all the contact dunks, but you're gonna be a little bit faster, so you don't lose any stats. I would just leave it the way it is. And also, my build when I hit 95 is gonna have 99 strength off the rip because I already hit superstar 3. You can body pretty much any big man. The only thing you're probably gonna struggle with is Paint Beast because they literally have like a 95 dunk. I mean, Paint Beast is really dunk on anybody, but you're gonna be dunking on them, which is the good part about it. Wingspan, I would go max. I mean, you're not gonna be shooting, right? You know what I'm saying? So why would you go minimum if you're trying to get blocks and dunk and everything? If you could just max it out, you know what I'm saying? There's no shot on this player. Definitely max out your wingspan and take over. I would go slashing takeover. It depends on your playstyle. If you want post score, I would make the 30 finishing one low key, because you get a 95 post hook. That's the one when you max out all your finishing. But if you want the one I made, I would definitely go slashing takeover. Even with a 30 finishing one, I'll go slashing takeover too. But it's all based on your playstyle. This player doesn't have a good of a hook, so I want to go post score. So if you want to get those easy rep, definitely slashing takeover. It gives you the exclusive animations. So now we're about to go test this build out. The badges and everything. If y'all still here, make sure to leave a like, comment down below, subscribe. Also comment active in the comment section. Badges, this is my personal preference, like you stuttering. Contact finisher, Hall of Fame, fancy footwork, acrobat, maybe silver or gold actually. I don't even know, to be honest. We'll figure it out. So these are like the main four if you're trying to get rep low-key. Relentless can come and go. Hall of Fame, we'll put that on. Backdown Punisher, it depends on your playstyle. Actually, this part's tough. I actually haven't even decided what I want to do with it. So I might go Acrobat, Silver, Pro Touch, Hall of Fame, and Consistent. If I have Pro Touch, I don't really need Consistent. I don't even know. I don't know. This is tough. I'm with y'all right now. I don't really know where to shoot. So I would actually go spread it out. Rewatching this, I would probably put Lob City, leave it on gold, yeah. And consistent, I don't know. If you have your meter on, I don't think you need consistent finisher unless you just can't time your layups. Rewatching that, so if you might want to put that in, back down or something, I don't know. You don't need Giant Slayer, you're gonna be tall anyway. Slithery, Hall of Fame, Pro Touch, fancy footwork, yeah. I don't know, it's honestly your preference, and you'll figure it out along the way. People say silver, slithery finisher works. So we might just leave it like that. And you never know though. So
That's, yeah, this part, low-key, you don't really know what to do with it. You're going to figure it out once you get all 20. That's a lot of finishing the grind. I'm at 14 at the moment, but with those clips, I probably had like 8 or 9. Like, honestly, bro, I was already catching bodies from the jump. It's crazy. And I had this player for about a week or two now, but testing him out, this build is definitely up there. It's very OP, easy rep. You could definitely rep up if you put your mind to it. Shooting doesn't matter. You're not going to be shooting, so maybe hot zone on here. Get that lucky shot. Playmaking, outdo, obviously quick first golds, post spin, maybe gold, silver, I don't know. Unblockable bronze, bailout. And the rest of these are probably going to be for like, so maybe downhill if I'm on threes, but twos, I don't even know. Needle threader, I might go silver unpluckable. Actually, yeah, maybe silver unpluckable because I'm a big man and everything. The ball control is weak. Oh, so one more. Unpluckable. No, I don't know. Yeah, what bailout goal? You want to make those risky bailouts. Maybe, I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how it goes, though. I don't even have all my playmaking. I probably have like 6. But, yeah. And defense, I'd go with this lineup right here. Probably get multiple stops. Maybe box gold or interceptor. I would put on interceptor. You still get the animations. If you're playing pass lanes, that's up to you. But yeah, that's that. That's how you make this build, man. Thank y'all for watching this video. Make sure you leave a like, comment down below, subscribe, and share. And I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace.